Welcome back. This is Kailmarie Jewell. This is Unit 5, Part 1, Developing Internet of Things, which is part of the subject Internet of Things, subject code 1590422E. This slide explains about the Unit 5 syllabus, which includes IoT platform design methodologies, IoT physical devices and endpoints, IoT systems, logical design using Python, IoT physical services and cloud offering. This explains the first topic, IoT physical devices and endpoints. This slide tries to explain about what can be the physical devices which contribute for the things in IoT. So basically, if you consider, the main components will be the microcontroller. There are so many types, but in this unit we are trying to take example of Raspberry Pi for better understanding. So we'll be studying about the Raspberry Pi interfaces and how to program using Python. And it is not necessary that you have to restrict to Raspberry Pi. There are other IoT devices like Arduino, ESP8266, BeagleBoard, and anything which favors can be considered. As I was telling, the word thing in the Internet of Things, T stands for things. So things in IoT usually refer to any device which can be uniquely identified using some kind of addressing. And looking into the capabilities, basically we look for three genres. So one is sensing, and local as well as remote sensing, actuation, and the monitoring. And now, what do? The devices basically collect information about the surrounding or environment. They can exchange data in order to have better insights. And the data which is collected can be either locally stored or sent it to a remote server, a centralized server, or a, as I told you, remote-based, in the sense it could be a cloud-based server where the application understands or gets insight based on the data collected. This slide is not new. It is just to bring in or emphasize again the basic building units of any IoT device, which we called as the thing. So as we saw, sensing is important, and actuation is doing some action. A sprinkler or a smoke detector, depending on finding the smoke, it then sprinkles water, or it can be on a smart irrigation. So anything which works or anything which actuates is your actuation, and sensor is sensing something around your environment and giving information about it, or temperature sensor for that matter. So sensing, actuation, and after you collect the data, you communicate. And after you communicate, you either do local analysis or a remote analysis, which involves basic processing, and you get the insight. So basic blocks of four: sensing, actuating, communication, analysis, and processing. As we have decided to consider Raspberry Pi, knowing about Raspberry Pi details is essential. So there are quick 4 points about Raspberry Pi. So it is a low-cost mini computer with a size as that of a credit card. So it's a very small computer. It runs on various flavors of Linux image, which makes it handy, and you don't have to learn any extra OS and operations. So it makes life very simple. VZ, Raspbian OS, Noobs, and all these comes as Linux flavors. And the Raspberry Pi, the whole idea is to connect sensors and actuators to make IoT work. So it helps in interfacing the sensors and actuators. How does it do? It has got general purpose I/O pins, and the language by which you can program the Raspberry Pi is Python. This slide gives an idea about the features in the board. So it has a processor, it has RAM, it has got USB ports, Ethernet ports, HDMI ports, so you can connect it to your monitor, desktop monitor. It has got a composite video output, audio output, GPIO, which is general purpose I/O pins. It has got a display serial interface, camera serial interface, so which makes the developers to connect camera directly to it. and it has got status LEDs to understand whether it is power on or off and whether transmission and reception is happening properly. It has got SD card slot in which you'll load your Linux image and the power input. This is the card, credit card size Raspberry Pi. There are so many variants. This is Raspberry Pi Model B, but you have Raspberry Pi 3 with advanced features. And Raspberry Pi 0 is also there, and which comes for low space or required projects, we can use it. And then if you look at the marking which is given in this slide, so you can have a look at the GPIO pins on top, which has got 40. And then RAM size, it is indicated here with 1 GB. All that, please recollect the features which I listed in the previous slide and try to visualize it here. Okay, so GPIO pins, 40, 1 GB RAM. Then I was trying to say about the camera interface, which is given here, which is CSI. And then your serial interface, display serial interface, DSI. I'm just traveling towards anti-clockwise, 40 GB, 1 GB RAM, DSI, CSI. Micro SD card where you put your SD cards, and then HDMI port, and then you have your audio jack and composite video, and then your Ethernet port for the internet, and then you have 4 USB ports, and then you have 3D graphics core as well. So the chip or the process, Broadcom. This explains about the Raspberry Pi interfaces. It has two kinds of interfaces, which is the popular protocol SPI as well as I2C, inter-integrated circuit. SPI stands for serial peripheral interface. And in SPI, you have MISO pin, master and slave out, master out slave in, MOSI, S-clock and the chip enable. And you have the SDA, the data line as well. And here you have two pins, SDA and S-clock. So in SPI, you actually have 4 pins, the MISO, MOSI, serial clock and the data. And here in I2C, it's just a two-line configuration protocol. It uses SDA and S-clock. This slide gives idea about the various Linux flavors on Raspberry Pi. As I've told you, you have this Raspbian OS, VZ, the basic noobs version, and then you have a lot of variants available. So this slide gives you an idea about a few of them. So the first one, as I told you, Raspbian Linux, and then you have this Arc, Fedora, OpenELC, RaspBMC, etc. And whichever you would like, you can just download and then put it in your SD card and start working on it.